Christ is risen.
Truly is risen.
Christos anviat.
Christos
oscresse.
Christos
incam.
Christos
anesti.
Christos
anesti. Resuscite. Christo la resuscitado. Christos is auferstanden. Christ is risen.
Truly is risen.
Diverse group. I have to cover all the bases. And that's only some. So I'm cheating today. I'm exhausted from Pascha and from Bright and Excited prepared sermon for this week. But I want to share with you a good word from the saints that follows along a little bit of what I was saying before we started liturgy today about the life coming forth from the tomb. And this is a homily called Christ Will Change Our Lowly Body, attributed to Saint Anastasios the Sinaite, Patriarch of Antioch, who entered into his rest 599 AD. Saint Anastasios, whose name means, of course, what? Resurrection. To this end, Christ died and rose to life, that he might be Lord both of the dead and of the living. But God is not God of the dead, but of the living. That is why the dead, now under the dominion of the one who has risen to life, are no longer dead, but alive. Therefore, life has dominion over them. And just as Christ, having been raised from the dead, will never die again, so too they will live and never fear death again. When they have been thus raised from the dead and freed from decay, they shall never again see death. For they will share in Christ's resurrection, just as he himself shared in their death. This is why Christ descended into the underworld with its imperishable prison bars, to shatter the doors of bronze and break the bars of iron, and from decay to raise our life to himself by giving us freedom in place of servitude. But if this plan does not yet appear to be perfectly realized, for men still die and their bodies still decay in death, this should not occasion any loss of faith. For in receiving the first fruits, we have already received the pledge of all the blessings we have mentioned. With them we have reached the heights of heaven, and we have taken our place beside him who has raised us up with himself. As St. Paul says, in Christ God has raised us up with him and made us to sit with him in the heavenly places. And the fulfillment will be ours on the day predetermined by the Father, when we shall put off our childish ways and come to perfect manhood. For this is the decree of the Father of the ages. The gift once given is to be secure and no more to be rejected by a return to childish attitudes. There is no need to recall that the Lord rose from the dead with a spiritual body, since St. Paul, in speaking of our bodies, bears witness that they are sown in animal bodies and raised as spiritual bodies. That is, they are transformed in accordance with the glorious transfiguration of Christ, who goes before us as our leader. And we should, by the way, just so you're clear, when he says, this is quoting St. Paul, we're sown in a corruptible body, we're raised in an incorruptible, sown in a carnal, fleshly body, raised in a spiritual body. Doesn't mean that we're saying he didn't have a bodily resurrection, but that his body had been transfigured and transformed. And we see that in the gospel today, that he is able to appear with them and then disappear. His body is no longer confined to the fleshly limits that we are limited to, but his body is most definitely resurrected. The apostle, affirming something he clearly knew, also said that this would happen to all mankind through Christ, who will change our lowly body to make it like his glorious body. This is not just about an amazing thing that happened once in history, but is in fact our destiny. If this transformation is a change into a spiritual body, and one, furthermore, like the glorious body of Christ, then Christ rose with a spiritual body, a body that was sown in dishonor, buried in dishonor, but the very body that was transformed in glory. Having brought this body to the Father as the first fruits of our human nature, He will also bring the whole body, that is all of us, to fulfillment. For he promised this when he said, I, when I am lifted up, will draw all mankind to myself. Through the prayers of the Holy Hierarch, Anastasios, O Christ our God, have mercy on us and save us.
Amen.
Amen. Christ is risen.
Truly is risen.
Christos hapsikosu fukatsu. Jido fu ole. Christ is risen.
Truly is risen.